Very fun. Little wolf, fuck off the sleep.
You're back at the moment, man.
Yeah.
Back at the fucking moment.
You'll feel, I promise you'll feel fucking great tomorrow morning. You wake up and you'll have tasks and you'll just don't sort of, you have made, like, you have said to her enough about observations about her and stuff.
Oh, yeah.
Just going, no. Like, yeah, just
where she's come. Nothing. She's not getting any of my observations, any of my insights, nothing at
yeah,
all.
Just, if she comes, just say, listen, you know, first, let's just make kiss and make up. Let's just, you know, do not try to just not. Say this, forget about it. Do not, if she's trying to open up the situation, don't.
Yeah, because it's funny, like, she tends to kind of want to open up the situation, but then get really pissed off at me for going on about it, even though I feel like it's her opening it up.
Yeah, so just...
So I just, like, I'm just going to... Well, the thing is, right, one thing I said this just in the diary room, like, is that I've noticed that in these conversations that go very negatively, I get a sense very early in the conversation that it's really not the kind of conversation I want to be having.
Mm.
But I kind of allow myself to be drawn into it anyway.
Mm.
Like, so as soon as I get that sense, this is not the kind of conversation I want to be having, stop it.
Yeah.
It'd be like, look, let's not talk about this right now.
Yeah,
or
that's so much
more relaxed, or even just stand up and walk away.
Mm.
But probably prefer to
just say, let's talk about this later.
Let's talk about something else.
Mm. Yeah, because it's really easy for you to try and want to really, when someone says something that you're like, oh, fuck, that's so wrong, I want to just explain.
Yeah.
And you're trying to explain, it's just going, bam.
Mm.
Some people, it's just really hard to explain to them things that they don't want to know about.
Yeah.
You know, it's really hard for some people. You can't force people to sit down and listen to you.
Mm.
That's the kind of people that when you talk, they talk over you.
Mm.
That's the kind of people you will never ever be able to try and like.
Not everyone has the patience with
listening to other people. It's like, you know, it's a lot of people in here. You're trying to, as long as it's something that they're happy to talk about, it's cool. As soon as you say something that you're not happy to talk about, they start screaming shout. So you will never be able to have a proper conversation, explain something to them the way that you want to. That's why when she came to me earlier, in front of everyone, she said, oh, what did you ask? Like, listen, if you want to talk about it, let's sit down. When Freddie comes out, me, you, Freddie, or just me and you, if you want, whatever. You know, I'm not going to say stuff that you say Freddie said, you know, when he's not here, because I don't know what he said.
Mm.
And with the stuff that she said again, I said, on that, I've got nothing to say, because I don't know what Freddie said.
Mm.
You saying he said that, I don't know what he said. So it's just with her. If I had that conversation earlier in front of everyone, as soon as I said any of the stuff I said, she would just go,
yeah.
You know, no, fuck this. You know, I'm not negative, you're negative, this is negative.
Yeah,
that's, you know, it's not, it's, you know, you have to choose your time very carefully. And some people just don't want to. It's really hard to. But it's best to have like one-on-one when it's a chill sort of mood.
Yeah.
When it's a bit of things going on, it's not a good time.
Yeah.
It's kind of hard, but you know, it's just like, it's the same. You know, that time with Chris, Charlie and Noreen, they sat me down and they said stuff to me. That's exactly the reason I came into the show.
Yeah.
To sort of make certain points. And they said everything. So that's why I was like, oh, fuck, I would just fall. I went to say, Biggie, I want to go. That's when I started, you know, I want to go off a nomination thing for eviction. Because I was like, this, I came to make the opposite thing.
Mm.
And this, everything they said just confirmed that I am being seen the way that I hate to be seen.
Yeah.
And that's the whole point of me coming on the show. And if I'm, everyone think that way, it's either I am that way or I'm not showing myself the right way. I just want to fucking leave.
Mm.
You know? But I sat down and they said stuff to me that's like the most horrible things that you can say to me personally. And I sat down and listened to them, everything they said. When I tried to explain to them back, they were fucking talking over me and didn't let me fucking properly explain myself. I did, like, you know, sort of made my points.
Mm.
But it was just, you know, it's hard. It's hard to get people to, you know, people just want to talk and just like, and as soon as you make any sort of points that is not really, they don't really want to hear, it's just like they start talking over it and it's just like, what is the point of a conversation if you're not You know, that's why I hate getting into arguments with certain people, especially, like, I like discussions, arguments, when you shout and stuff, you know. Because you can never explain things, because people just, you know, shouting. And where's all go? Tomorrow will be good. Again, just trust me, you know, trying to, just don't go back and trying to explain and just sort of say, like, forget about everything.
Oh, it's yeah, yeah, definitely.
Make a fresh start, because it's not explaining, it's not gonna...
Yeah, that's my... Yeah. That's good advice, Sivash, thank you.
And you're not trying to, you know, enlighten her with any sort of...
No.
Because
no.
It's just not going to, it's just going to come...
No, it's not the place.
...back and...
Bite, the time for that is if we... Well, she can do that on her own, actually, just watching this afterwards.
Yeah.
You know, like...
Yeah.
It's not,
well,
like...
Fair enough, if, you know, if you
guys... It would be different if this was week two.
Yeah, that would be very different.
But it's week fucking 10. So
it's not enough time. She's not going to be in here enough anyway.
Mm. Yeah.
Even if even if she says to the end and stuff, it's still not enough. Not enough time, because from here on, 2 weeks left. Last week doesn't even count, and these 2 weeks is just so close to the end. Mm. Everything will just be like, shh, shh, shh. Big Brother's going to do stuff like they've been in these 3 days, because it's towards the end. They want to make it, that, you know, milk it as much as they can. Stuff. So just gonna be so much will be going on,
yeah,
that there's no time for teaching people any sort of, like,
yep,
life lessons and stuff. It's just not.
Yep.
You just put yourself in a difficult.
Absolutely, absolutely. And the thing that, yeah, like.
Do you remember all this? I said to you.
All that I said in terms of life lessons was, I think you're more judgmental than you think you are. And that's something that she could go away and think about, basically.
I remember you said to me, I don't know when he was, and he said, like, I'm going to go make more understanding between people,
yeah,
make people understand themselves and the situation. I said, Freddie, my man, I promise you, no one in this house wants to understand themselves or want to understand any situation. They came in here thinking a certain way, they're going to leave this house thinking the same way.
Rodrigo seems to be quite receptive to that.
Yeah, but that's the same. He is that kind of guy.
Yeah.
That's the way he came into the house, that's the way he's going to leave.
Yeah, okay.
But if you are like stone, you're not going to take anything in.
Mm.
You came in the house that like that, and you're going to leave the house that way.
Yeah, that's true.
And if you're someone who's open to learning stuff and, you know, understand the situation, you are going to do that anyway. That's what I was saying, like, you know, choose your people. Ah, I said to you then as well. I said, me, Marcus, and I said Rodrigo.
Yeah.
I said back then as well, I said, you know, Rodrigo's. And you said the same thing. You said Rodrigo's. And I said, yeah, fair enough. So talk to Rodrigo about it.
Mm.
Well, yeah, now there's no need, you know, it's all done. It's finished.
Mm.
So it's no need to make any observation to anyone. You know, I'm still happy to listen and put my side of the story into it. I'm sure Marcus is. So I don't think, you know, especially because everybody's saying, oh, you overanalyzing things and stuff.
You what?
Overanalyzing things and stuff. Mm-hmm.
I really don't think I have been overanalyzing.
Yeah,
stuff,
I don't think you have. I don't think you have at all. But it's just the way people...
No, people think it because B keeps saying it.
Yeah. So it's just... By you, for example, saying...